everyone. As many of you know, I am a high-profile supporter of UNHCR, the UN Refugee Agency. We have been doing bits and pieces together over the last, gosh, like 8 years, which is absolutely wild. And a couple of weeks ago, they invited me to a launch event for Neil Gaiman's new book, What You Need to Be Warm. If that title's sounding familiar to you, here's why. In 2019, Neil Gaiman sent out a tweet on the Bird app and asked, "What reminds you of warmth?" People replied in their thousands. Neil wrote a poem from those replies. That poem then became a scarf, it became a short film, and now it is a beautiful hardback book retailing at £12.99. This book is out now and it will be rolling out in different languages over the next few months as well. You can buy it at unhcr.org/keepwarm. And I really enjoyed having the opportunity to talk to Oliver Jeffers, who designed the cover, and Nadine Kaadan, who did one of the illustrations inside. And I think I'm biased, but I think it's my favourite illustration in the collection. I loved my conversations with Oliver and Nadine, and I'm really excited to share them with you, so I hope you enjoyed them. And I'd love to hear in the comments what you need to be warm. There we go. It's a call to action, people.
I can't even remember what year it is, but it was, I suppose it was last year.
Yeah.
Or this year, maybe. The request came through, and I know, Neil, we're friendly, and you know, we've both been avid supporters of trying to do what we can to spread both empathy and just energy and visibility to the growing refugee crisis that's happening around the world for myriad reasons. And so as soon as I was asked to do the cover, I kind of knew exactly what image I would make, just yeah. the simplicity of warming your hands by the hearth and the foreignness of not feeling like you're welcome somewhere where, you know, borders are man-made problems that require man-made solutions.
And you said it's all pencil, all coloured pencil.
Oh, well, yes, it's all coloured pencil. The hands and the countries are graphite, the rest is black coloured pencil and orange coloured pencil. Do you know, here's the people are afraid of the blank page, but as soon as you put a mark on it, it's not a blank page anymore, and then you've got something to react against.
Yeah.
But whenever people do ask me what I do if I get stuck and don't know what to do next, it's like, you just remember you'll be dead soon.
Yeah.
And nobody's going to do it for you.
Yeah, you just got to keep going.
Yep.
So at the point where you were designing the cover, did you know that the artwork throughout was going to be black and orange?
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
That was made pretty clear. And, you know, it's like whenever requests like this go out, it's good to know, okay, when's it needed for? What are the specifications? What are the rules essentially, and then it's easier to be able to react within those. So right away I was like, it's this size, we need front and back cover, two color, and we need it in, I think it was like in 3 weeks or something. So
oh wow,
yeah,
quite a quick one.
Yep.
Yeah, I love that the open door, like the warm welcome.
Yeah,
I love the fire. And it also, when I was watching you all speak earlier, I was thinking, oh, it's also like, you know, the heart, the core of the earth.
Exactly. Yeah. So you know, it's the exactly that. It's like the magma center of the warmth and the internal warmth of the planet. But it's, you know, it's every home has a hearth, but whether real or metaphorical. And speaking of the metaphor here,
yeah. And what does a warm welcome mean to you?
I think warm welcome, really, it means it's hospitality. It's mm-hmm. inviting somebody in and sharing what you have with somebody who you've either invited in or somebody who needs your help.
And at this time of year especially, but also in different times of year in different parts of the world, a lot of refugees are experiencing particularly cold mm-hmm. conditions, particularly harsh conditions. So I think it's really impactful to be reminded that warmth just looks different for different people.
Warmth looks different for different yeah. people. It's an idea as well as a physical state of being.
Yeah.
And I think even the fact that that somebody like Neil thought to make this book is probably a warming thought for many people who otherwise feel unseen.
I love how many people are involved, not just in terms of composing the poem, but also the number of illustrators, a mm-hmm. few of whom we heard from mm-hmm. this evening. And it really, I think, it's just so encouraging to have so many people mm-hmm. heartily stepping up for refugees.
We're a collective organisation, humanity, yeah. really, aren't we? We work best in numbers.
Yeah.
When we come together, we solve things, and when we divide ourselves, we tend to create problems that need solving.
You talked a little bit on the panel about your project, The Heart of It. Can you say a bit more?
Well, that's a poem from my book, The Begin Again, which is about the... It's not unlike this. It's a lot more elaborate and very specific about the trajectory of the human story and mm-hmm. where it does seem like we've all gone wrong and where it is we need to go next. Mm-hmm. And just really, I think, reminding people of the simplicity of what it is that we need, but to re-question their own motivations in a very fractured world and to remind people that the the most important story of all is the story that you tell yourself as a way to propel yourself forward into an unknown future.
Yeah, I think that's wonderful. Years and years ago, I used to work at a children's bookshop, and I remember there I was introduced to your book, The Heart in the Bottle, mm-hmm. and that was so moving to me, and I lost my dad when I was pretty young, and I just found so much comfort in that book. Where do you find comfort in reading, in art? Where are your places to go?
I think for comfort for me is, it's definitely family. It is, I do a lot of processing through the act of making art, but mm-hmm. I think it's, yeah, relaxing times with family. I tend to relax most when, not work, when I'm either cooking or playing sports. It's the only times where there's something that's engaging my thought process more than any art-related project will. But I think comfort is, it's about home and it's about time with people that you love.
Yeah. I'm here now with Nadine Kaadan, who is one of the illustrators in the book, What You Need to Be Warm. And your spread, I think I marked it, is this one, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
So beautiful.
Thank you.
So this is... And what materials did you use to make this illustration?
I've only used watercolour, so I always use watercolour. On the top I use coloured pencils. Yeah. I tried to use other materials, I failed. It's the thing that I feel represent me the most.
Yeah, so watercolours, with a project like this, you'd start with a blank page, presumably.
Yeah.
How do you start with the first mark on the page?
I'm very traditional, so I'm one of those who can't use computer, although computer can make your life easier. If you make a mistake, you can fix it. I need to see a painting.
Yes.
So I start with lots of sketches, then like really light pencils, then layers and layers of watercolors, and I ended up with pencils on the top, with colored pencils on the top.
I love it. I feel like this whole book has so many different mediums and textures.
Yeah, it does.
And the actual book itself is such nice quality. It's like, it's just really lovely. You spend time with the images. And so you're from Syria yourself, mm-hmm, and you've made a journey that is both similar and different to the people who come up in this book, and also to many people around the world right now. Can you speak a little bit about what it was like for you coming to the UK in terms mm-hmm. of welcome, and where there was warmth and maybe where there was less?
I mean, I am one of the very lucky few that when we came to the UK, I booked a flight,
yeah,
and I came. I had the option to that. I have the privilege of that. And I can't even think of my friends who I grew up with and I was raised with, that they didn't have that privilege.
Mm-hmm.
And they had to go through dangerous journey and face so many borders and go through hell to find safety. And it's really unfair. And think of humanity and what defines us, and why it's not the case for everyone. Why people, when they decide that this is not safe for me, I need to leave, they can't just find a safe journey, they can't just book a flight. What defines our humanity? Is it a piece of paper? Is it a document? Is it a passport? It breaks my heart, and I really don't know what to tell my children. I mean, why some people are treated differently than other people? Because this is not what we want to raise them. We want to tell them everyone is equal.
Yeah.
So I have been lucky in that way. I booked a flight, but that doesn't mean that wasn't painful. I mean, being forced to leave, it's horrible. And for me, I said it's going to be only 1 year, and I was never planning on staying. And every year we would say, we'll stay another year, and we stay another year, and we stayed here until today. So it is hard, and it's... And home is still home for me. It's still Syria, and it still represents me, still who I am. It makes my books, it makes my illustration and my creative work.
And it's Damascus you're from.
Damascus, yeah.
And you spoke on a panel about how this is a very typical Damascene house.
Yeah, yeah,
which
yeah.
It's beautiful, right? And so this for you is also what it means to be warm as home.
Yeah, yeah. The beauty about Damascus is the houses are very, very modest on the outside. I wish I have images to show you. The houses are really modest on the outside, so as you can see, it's a really simple design. There isn't a dome really, it's just a flat roof and simple wooden doors. But when you go inside, it's so grand and so beautiful, and that represents the modesty of the people. And inside, you see in every old Damascus house, there is fountain and arches and beautiful courtyard full of orange trees and jasmine. And it's a very sensory experience, Damascus, because you always hear the trickle of the water, you smell the jasmine, the shades and the sun, the contrast between them. So this is where I was raised, and it represents warmth for me.
Yes. And how do you say warm in Arabic?
Dafa.
Dafa.
Well done.
I took a class for 3 weeks. And then it was really hard on Zoom because she kept covering up the words she was writing. But she was writing, and so I was like, "Oh, wait till I can do this in person again."
Yeah, Zoom. I would say it's quite tricky.
Zoom Arabic is tricky.
Well, I salute you for trying.
Oh,
on
thank
Zoom.
You.
Yeah.
Thank you. But I really want to learn more. And then another question I was going to ask, because you've created a lot of work, you've received many awards, and been nominated for many, but these themes come up for you in all of your work, and as you said on the panel as well, it's of course because it's your life, these stories are infused in every element of them. Why do you think images are so powerful in terms of conveying these conversations, in terms of art, in terms of storytelling?
Because they tell things that words cannot tell, and they let people see what they want to see.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I love about illustrations. I find them as stimulating as words, and in some occasion I found just it has the freedom for people to see them the way they want to see them.
Mm-hmm.
And to tell their own stories in every illustration. So they are very powerful, the darkness of it very powerful. I mean, a lot of my books, kids ask me about the illustrations, and I love how they see the illustrations differently, because I illustrate in a kind of metaphor, symbolic way. So for example, my book Tomorrow is about the war, and a lot of the illustrations has metaphor in them. And kids ask me, but why did you draw that way? Why did you draw that looks like a building? And I would ask, why do you think that way? And they have different answers, and I say, yes, exactly, because there isn't a correct or wrong answer. It's how you see it, how you feel it, and that's the beauty of illustrations. It's beyond words. It's really for the people to see what they want to see in it, and to go through a journey of emotions.
It's very co-created, isn't it? Like you bring something to it. And you also said on the panel that you don't normally work with black, and that you were a little scared of black, which was, I thought, so interesting. Did you illustrate this in orange? Did you have that brief already?
Yeah.
The black and orange. Okay, so
yeah.
they didn't change this afterwards.
No.
This came in with you. But then, yeah, working with black is a very different... You're working with so many different shades.
I didn't do it black, to be honest. I did
yeah.
it dark blue.
Yes.
Succulent.
Yes.
I really can't illustrate with black. I'm
yeah.
sorry. So I did it dark blue, and I said, I mean, you do the rest, basically. You make it black if you want to. And so the original illustration is different shades of dark blue. I don't know why I'm scared of black. And in fact, actually, it was so good to be part of the book, not only because it's a topic that I'm so passionate about, and it represents me and a lot of Syrians, basically, leaving our country, but also because I was pushed out of my comfort zone, and then suddenly I want to work on a medium that I don't work usually, and try to see myself in black, illustrate for older children. I was happy, yeah. I was happy to see if I'm stretched, what the result can be.
Yeah, I'm glad, because it turned out absolutely stunning.
Oh,
and and that's in the book, What You Need to Be Warm, which is available now, and all proceeds go to UNHCR, the UN Refugee Agency.
Thank you so much to Nadine and to Oliver for taking the time to speak with me. Please visit unhcr.org/keepwarm, where you can find ways to buy this book. You can also buy it, of course, at your local bookshop. And you can also find out more about UNHCR's Winter Appeal, ways to save lives and give a little extra warmth to refugees who are facing extreme weather conditions. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to finding out what you need to be warm in the comments. Bye.